Good morning, everyone. This is Ishani with IB Professional School. Today we are doing a webinar on the functions, very important functions called match, index, and lookup. And this webinars are a part of the webinar series that we are conducted at IB. We are going to conduct a webinar related to the topic in analytics on Excel Access or SAS and statistics every week. So let's start with the functions of match, index. Now, I believe people who are attending this webinar would have a knowledge of VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. So, what we are going to do after learning these functions of match and index, we are going to try and make our VLOOKUP functions a little more dynamic. And we are going to try and overcome the limitations of VLOOKUP using these functions. So, let's just start by understanding what does a match function do for me. Basically, match function helps us to find the relative position of an element in an array. Now, when you talk about array in match, we are talking about one-dimensional array. What do you mean by one-dimensional array? One-dimensional means we either pick a row or we pick a column. It cannot be a table. So, from a row and a column, if I'm looking or searching for something and I want to find the position of that element, I'm going to use a function called match. Let's look at the syntax of match. The syntax is lookup value, lookup array, and match type. Pretty much similar to what we are used to looking in VLOOKUP as well. Now, what is a lookup value? Lookup value is something that I'm searching for. Now, in this case, unlike the VLOOKUP, I'm not trying to extract value corresponding to my lookup value. What the aim is? Aim is to find the relative position in an array. So, I'm trying to find the position of this lookup value in my array. The second thing is lookup array. Like we discussed, lookup array is an array which has to be one dimension, means either one row or one column. And then the match type. So, looking at this example that we have over here, if you look in the column B, I've got set of incomes 0, 100, 200, 300, 400 and so on and so forth. And then we've got some allowance 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, if we are going to find the relative position of income 310, right? Now 310 is not available in our list. Again, I'm going to go back to VLOOKUP. In VLOOKUP, we again have a range lookup of 0 and 1, where 0 depicts exact match and 1 depicts approximate match. Similarly, in your match, we also have a match type. We have the match type of either 0, 1 or minus 1. If I have a match type, so the match type are going to be 0, 1 and minus 1. Now, what do you mean by 0? 0 means again trying to find the exact lookup value and giving its position. If we are using 1, 1 is used in approximate match and your array has to be in ascending order. When you talk about minus 1, we are trying to find the position when our match type is approximate, but our array is in descending order. Right? Now, the example that we are taking today of income, our array is in ascending order, starting from 0 all the way to 700. And we are trying to find the position of income called of 310. So, in this case, we are going to start with the match function. Lookup value would be 310, which lies in the cell C19, comma, lookup array, one dimension. So we are going to select the cells. If I'm going to omit the blank cell on the top, then the position starts from 0. But if I'm going to pick starting from 0, then position number 1 is where number 0 is. That is the cell B9. Right, so I'm going to pick the array of B9 to B16, comma, and in our match type we've got 0, 1 and minus 1. So over here, since our array is in ascending order, we are going to pick 1. Once we do that, we are getting an answer of 4. The relative position of 310 is 4. How did 4 come up? Now 310 lies between 300 and 400. 310 lies between 300 and 400, and what it returns is the position of the lower bound. 300 being a lower bound for 300 and 400, it is going to pick the position of 300. That's why we've got the position 4 over here. Now, if I was to reverse this thing, like say we are going to have incomes from 700 to 0 and I had descending order, then let's see how it behaves. So 700, 600, and let's just populate all the way to 0. Okay, let's say this is my array, and again I'm going to find the position of 310. So in such case, let's start with match. Lookup value is 310, which is C19, comma. Now my lookup array is in descending order. And match type would be -1 because I'm finding approximate position but of descending order. So -1. And now I got again the position number 4. Now how did I get position number 4? Again 310 lies between 300 and 400. However, when you're doing match with -1, it returns the relative position of the upper limit of that range. So it is returning the position of number 400 rather than returning the position of number 300. So that is your -1 and 1 approximation in your match function. Now, what about exact match? Just like in VLOOKUP, when we did exact match, it used to return us an answer only when it found the exactly matching lookup value. So, over here, the same thing will happen. If I find 310 in my data, only then it will return, else it would not return anything. So, if I'm going to do an exact match with 310 equal to match function, lookup value, cell C19, comma, lookup array, I'm going to pick this ascending order data, comma, 0, which is the exact match, and enter. It is going giving #NA, which stands for not available. Why does this thing came? Because 310 does not exist in an array. There is no exactly matching value over here. So let's try to do the exact match again for the allowance field. Over here, we have got 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And let's see if we are going to do a match. Our lookup value is allowance, comma, which is C20. However, our lookup array is not a vertical array anymore. It's a horizontal array. It's in a row because this is where the value of allowances are. So we're going to pick this array from here, comma, 0, because I want the exact match of it. And we press enter. We get 3. Third position is number 2. So the function of match is to give you positions. Now, how does it help me to learn a function like this in VLOOKUP? Let's go back and look at one of the problems in VLOOKUP. Let's say this is my complete table where I've got transaction IDs, region, customer, product, cost of goods sold, and sales. And from this whole table, entire table, there are approximately 1840 records over here. From this entire, I want to find certain information or I want to extract certain information of, let's say, 10 transaction ID. We know that whenever we are doing a function where it involves extraction from a table within the same worksheet or different workbooks, we are going to use VLOOKUP or HLOOKUP as our tools. In this case, we are populating a table with transaction ID, which is given to us, and we want customer, product, and sales. Now, in this situation, if we are working with VLOOKUP, how are we going to work? We start with equal to VLOOKUP. Lookup value is going to be the transaction ID over here, comma. Table array is this entire table because my lookup value has to be the first column of my table array, and first column happened to be transaction ID. So I'm going to select the entire table, comma. Now comes the column index number. For column index number, basically I have to find where is my column that says, one second. Okay, so I want to find out where is the column index number for customer. So normal way, if you're using a simple VLOOKUP, is you'll go back to your table array, and start counting in which column is your customer data. So we go 1, 2, 3. So third column is customer. So we put a column index number of 3, comma 0 for exact match. And we press enter. So we got the customer Nature Company. Now if we want the product and the sales as well, what we have to do after fixing certain things, let's fix the lookup value. I'm going to fix the column because my lookup values are in a fixed column. I'm going to completely fix my table array and I copy paste for product and sales. Now what is happening? I'm getting the same value for Nature Company for product and sales, which is incorrect. The reason behind that is the column index number. The column index number, when we are writing functions and we are copy pasting VLOOKUP, is a number has been given over there, which is a fixed thing. It's not a formula. It doesn't have a cell reference that it will keep on changing, right? So manually we have to go in the formula and change the column index number. Now for product, the column index number is 4, and for sales, the column index number is 6. So I have to manually put 4, and over here we put 6, and we get our answer. What are the limitations when I'm working with VLOOKUP like this? The limitations are, first of all, I can make error when I'm counting, I'm doing a manual count. So to reduce on the manual count, I should be using something which is more dynamic in nature. Second, I only have 3 columns right now over here. What if I have 15 columns to populate? Then I am going to waste a lot of time populating all those 15 columns. And anytime I'm making change to one, I'll have to individually go and make changes to all. So to overcome all these problems, what we try to do is we make match as a function. We are going to use match. Now, what are we doing? Where are we trying to find a relative position of any element in an array? We are trying to find the position of the column index number. That is something that we are looking for. Now, how do we do that? If I have to manually do it, what we do, we look at this field over here on top of the table that we have to populate. Over here, it's written customer. Once we find out this field, we go to our table array. And in table array, then we are going to find the exact match of customer, right? And where do you look for it? You are not going to look for it vertically, but we are seeing in which header field has this thing. So we only look in the header field of the table array. So let's look at, I'm just going to populate first the column index number on the top, and then we are going to mix and match with VLOOKUP to make it dynamic. So let's start with match. Like I told you, the reason we are trying to use match over here is to get automatically our column index number to reduce the manual intervention over there. So we are going to select the header in our table that we are going to populate, that is I4, I5. We are going to select I5. We are trying to look for I5 in the array on the top over here. And we want an exact match, so we put a 0. Once I press enter, automatically I got a column index of 3. Now same thing if I have to do for product and sales. Again, we are going to use a concept of cell referencing. I'm going to fix the value of I5, I'm going to fix my row and I'm going to fix my table array. Once I've done that, I can drag it, copy paste it, and I've got column index number of 3 for customer, for product, column index number of 4, and for sales, a column index number of 6. Now, what is the beauty of using this? The beauty is, irrespective, if I change the fields over here, I do not have to go back to my formula and change it again. Automatically, column index number would change and the exact proper values will get extracted. Now, I'm going to put this formula, copy it from here, go to my function of VLOOKUP, and where I had manually put 3, I'll paste the match function. Once this is done, now I'm going to copy this function and paste it for the entire table. So I made a function that works for the entire table. I do not have to make individual formulas for each and every column. Now if I don't want product, I wanted information of, let's say, region. instead of product, I want region. So I can quickly go and type in region. As soon as I do that, automatically my column of region is populated. But if I did not have the understanding or the knowledge of match, I would have to again go back to my table array, manually count where region is, go in my function, change the column index number, copy paste again. So that reduces your work quite a bit and it becomes very error free. The only thing that you have to understand when you're using VLOOKUP and MATCH is that your column headings of the table array and the table that you're populating. This is my table array over here from column A to F, and this is my table that I'm populating from H to K. The headers need to exactly match. If the headers do not match, for example, in region, if I put an extra space at the end, now this region and the region that I have in my table that I want to populate is not the same. As soon as I've done this, it has become not available. Why? Because it's not able to find the position. And hence, in the place where you had your match function, this is returning a hash array value. Not available. And that's why the whole VLOOKUP is returning you an error message. So be very sure that you are having the same header for the table that you're extracting from and the table that you're extracting to. Any questions? Okay, now let's move on to what was the limitation of VLOOKUP. One big limitation of VLOOKUP is that VLOOKUP cannot look towards left of a lookup value column. The reason is, if I have something which is to the left of my lookup value, it cannot be picked as a part of my table array. And something that cannot be picked as a part of my table array, it cannot be extracted. Right? So what we are going to do, we are going to try and overcome. I think there is a... Your voice is breaking. Is it fine now, Shekhar? So let's see how we can overcome the limitation that we have. Okay, to overcome the limitation of this, we have actually two methods that we can use. One is, we are going to use another function which is called index. Again, index is a function that helps us to extract the data, or you can use a function called lookup function. Though in industry, index would be used more than the lookup function. So let's go and look at the index function. Let's first understand basic what is an index function, and then let's try to see whether it's actually overcoming our VLOOKUP limitation or not. So over here, we've got a table. We've got the part ID, part 1, part 2, part 6, and we've got quantity 1, 5, 2500. Now, depending on what part ID and what quantity you are picking, some percentage discount you will be availing in buying it. So basically, this is a very similar situation that we have in VLOOKUP, where we are looking for one thing in a different column and we're extracting a value. So first, let us look at the syntax of index function. Index function, the syntax is index, you talk about the array, you talk about the row number, and you talk about the column number. Now, what do you mean by array? See, index is much simpler versus VLOOKUP to understand, because over here, no ifs and buts are involved when you're picking an array. Array over here in index is going to be the entire table. So you don't have to worry, where is my lookup value, does it exist on the right or left, nothing. So array means the entire table that you're going to pick, from which we are going to look for certain things and extract it. Now, the way index works is based on the position rather than finding out where is the exact match and going to a particular column. So if this is my entire array, what I have to give it to index in the second argument is which row number you want to go and extract the value. And then the third argument is, out of this array, which column now you want me to go and extract the value. Now, for example, let's see over here, we've got a part ID, part 5, and we want the quantity. We are buying for part ID, part 5, we are buying 5 paths for that particular ID. So we want to find out how much discount are we receiving, right? Simple extraction. So we start with index. Array, like I told you, we're going to pick the entire table. Common question that comes up is, do I pick the entire table with the headers or don't pick the headers? It actually doesn't matter too much. So the difference that will come is the row number and the column number. You have to understand, if I'm picking the header of part ID slash quantity, this is my row number one. This is my row number two. But if I miss my headers, if I'm not picking the header at a part of my array, then the part one is where my row begins. So first thing I'm picking this entire table as my array, comma, row number. If I'm looking for part five, in which row is part five in this particular table? So I can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, sixth row. So I put sixth row, comma, which column does the quantity of 5 lie? 1, 2, 3. So I put 3, and as soon as we enter, we get 20%, which is the answer for part ID part 5 and the quantity 5. Now, a question might come up saying that it's a small table, it's easy to count. What if we have a larger table? What if I have 10,000 rows of data? Then I'm not going to sit and count my row number because it's tedious and I can make errors in it. So again, to make this function dynamic and to make it usable, we are going to introduce match in it. Because in row number and column number, the only thing we are doing is finding the position of that particular value in an array. When we are talking about row, we are finding the position in a vertical table, vertical array. And we're talking about the column number, we are trying finding the position of that element in a row array. So let's just try to make this thing dynamic. So again, I'm going to use index. Array is going to be this entire table again, comma. For the row number, I need a match. Lookup value, since I'm talking about row, to find row, I need something which is vertically placed. So out of part 5 and 5, vertically placed thing is part 5. So this becomes my lookup value, comma. Lookup array, again, since I'm finding in row and all my paths are kept in a vertical array, this is going to be my array for part 5, comma, 0, because I'm looking for exact match. Whenever we are using match with VLOOKUP or index to find the relative position, please remember we are going to use the exact part of the match type and match function. Comma. Now we are in the third argument, which is the column number. Again, we are trying to find a position. So we are going to use the match function again. Lookup value, vertical. I'm going to pick my quantity of 5. Where am I going to find it? I'm going to pick the array which has all the quantities. That's a horizontal array. Comma, 0 for exact match. Closing the bracket for this match. Closing the bracket, end of index function. We press enter. We get again. If I convert this into percentage, I get 20%, which is the right answer. So now what will happen if I change this to part number 1? My formula, which is dynamic, has automatically picked the right value. But the one where I had manually counted my row and column is still the same. So again, it is not very advisable to use index without match. Whenever you are using index function, please try to use match, because only then it's practical to use that particular function. Anybody has any questions? Okay, moving on to see how it's going to help me in my VLOOKUP. Now we're going to go back to this table, and what I'm going to do is just cut this transaction ID and place it over here. So my first column is now region, followed by transaction ID, followed by customer, product, cost of goods sold, and sales. Now let's see, I have the answer. I know the my lookup value is transaction ID again. But over here, what I'm trying to extract is customer, region, and sales. Region happened to be on the left side of my transaction ID. If I use a VLOOKUP function along with a match, So since my transaction ID is my lookup value, my table array is going to start from transaction ID. We put match function. And in match, we are going to look for customer, lookup value, the table array starting from transaction ID, that is the table header of my table array is my lookup value for match, 0 for exact match, comma, 0 for exact match of VLOOKUP, and we press enter, we get our answer of nature company. We can do the proper fixing the column edge, fixing our table array, fixing the row in case of match, fixing the lookup array, and then we go to copy paste. Now what happened? Customer value came, sales came, however region did not come, just because it does not exist in our table array. To overcome this, we are going to use a combination of index and match. So let's start it. Equal to index array. Now like I said, over here we do not have a restriction of which should be my first column. So I can pick the entire array starting from wherever I want. Now since I'm extracting region also, I'm going to pick the region as well in my array. Comma. Next thing is row number. Like we understood now, for row number and column number, we are going to use a function of match. Now, what is going to give me the row number? I have two things that I know. I have a transaction ID called ABC. -2398, and I know for this transaction ID I need the customer information. So out of these two, whatever is vertically placed would be taken up as a lookup value of the first match for your row number, and this happens to be vertically placed, the transaction ID. So this becomes my lookup value, comma, where will I find this transaction ID? I'm going to find it in the column of transaction ID, so I select that, comma. Again, one thing you have to notice, when I pick my array, I pick my headers as well. So in match, you have to make sure that you pick your header in your lookup array as well, because otherwise your counting will be off by one. Okay, going back, 0 for the exact match, comma, third argument, column index number. So match, lookup value for column index number, which is going to give the column number, is going to be through these fields. I want to find in which column I need to go. So customer will be my lookup value, comma, and where will be my lookup array? The entire header of my array, comma, 0 for exact match, closing column index number, closing your index, and enter. Again, let's do proper referencing. Arrays always need to be fixed, irrespective which function you are using. In match, I'm H6 represents the transaction ID, which is placed vertically. So I'm going to fix my column. Again, this is an array fixing. In match, I5 represents these fields of customer, region, and sales, which is horizontally placed. So I'm going to fix my row. And then I'm going to fix my lookup array again. Once this is done, copy paste for the entire table, and I get my answer. So this is how we're going to overcome our problem of going and extracting the values from the left side of your table. Any questions? Okay, for the same purpose, there is another function which is called lookup function. But the problem, there is a slight problem in the lookup function, hence it's not very popular with the industry. But just let's quickly go through what is a lookup function. If you type in equal to lookup, let's look at the syntax. The syntax is lookup value, lookup vector, result vector. What is a lookup value? Again, something that you are looking for. Again, lookup is used for extraction purpose. Lookup vector would be the row or the column from where you're trying to look up what is the position of your lookup value. And result vector would be the row or column from where you're trying to extract once you found the position of the lookup value. Small example, let's say I am looking for the transaction ID ABC. For the transaction ID ABC 239H, I am looking for customer. Okay, so
I'm just going to copy this and make a small table at the bottom. I'm looking for customer information. So I use my lookup function. Lookup value is this ID because I'm looking for this, comma. Now where can I find the position of this lookup ID? In the column of where I'm given the transaction ID. So I'll go to the transaction ID column and I select the entire column. From here, it has to look for where is my lookup value. Once I've found my lookup value, what do I need to extract? I want the information of my customer. So result vector would be this column. Only the column. Only in the column. Then we close our brackets. So we've got a lookup value in H19. B3 to B1841 is our lookup vector. And C3 to C1841 is our result vector. We press enter. What we got over here is solar and wind. But if you notice, when we ran our index and when we used our VLOOKUP, the actual answer is nature company. So what went wrong? The thing with lookup is, whenever you're using this function, this hitch is that your lookup vector from where you're searching for your lookup value has to be always sorted in ascending order to get the right answer. Our lookup vector is transaction ID. So I'm going to go quickly and sort A to Z, and as soon as I do that, I get the correct answer. Because of this small slight problem that we have to do, that we have to arrange a data, especially the lookup vector, in an ascending order, that is why it is not very popular. And if you're doing a multi-column, in case you had to do a column, you have to populate a column like this. Right? It is, but it's going to be very tedious. But you look up, if you look up, value is remaining the same.
No, but you can do it, you can't use match in the.
Where will you use match in this?
The second part where you look up vector.
Lookup vector is a whole column. You have to pick an array. Match gives you the position. Right. So just to recap what we've done in lookup, the syntax of lookup function was lookup value, lookup vector, result vector. Lookup value, whatever is the lookup value, we take that. We go to the lookup vector where we can find the position of the corresponding lookup value. Once we find the corresponding position, whatever we give as a result vector, it goes to that particular row or column and extracts the value from there. Things that we need to remember while using this function is that the lookup vector has to be arranged in an ascending order in order to get a right answer. Otherwise, we do not get the right answer. That is used, that assumes. The second syntax is lookup value and an array. So it is not asking you what is the lookup vector and what is the result vector. Second syntax is used when you are assuming, there's an assumption involved that you are always looking from the first column and you're always returning answer from the last column of your array, which might not be the case in most of the 90% of the cases. Hence, it's not used too much. Right? Anybody has a question? So this is these are all the things that we were supposed to cover for today. So what we did today was match function. We saw how we use match with VLOOKUP to make our VLOOKUPs dynamic. Then we also saw the index function, which helps us to overcome one of the limitations of VLOOKUP. That is when we have to extract a value from the left side. And again, we use the match function in index to make it dynamic. Then we saw another function called lookup function, which does the same thing as index. We can go ahead and get values from the left side of a lookup value, but there's a small problem of arranging the data in a certain order, which needs to be remembered all the time when you're working this function. Hence, it's not very popular.
So in case you guys have any questions regarding the functions that we have used, you can always send us email at info@ivyproschool.com, and I'll be more than happy to help you out. Thank you.